Good morning and welcome to story time. Today I'm Miss Sharon and today we're going to read about noise. So think about the noises that you hear every day. Cars and trucks and dogs and cats and maybe a brother or sister, or I know you guys aren't noisy, right? You're really good and quiet and everything. Okay, so we're going to start with our opening song. The more we get together, 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 the more we get together, the happier we'll be. 'Cause your friends are my friends and my friends are your friends. The more we get together, the happier we'll be. Okay. First book is called Holler Loudly by Cynthia Leach Smith, illustrated by Barry Gott, and read with the permission of Dutton Children's Book. Do you think he's going to be loud? Mama and Daddy Loudly named their baby Holler because he cried so loud. So loud that the pecans fell from the pecan trees and the prickly pear cacti sprouted more needles. So loud that every hound dog in the county rolled up his ears, tossed back his head to bay. So loud the armadillos woke from their naps and the turkey vultures dropped their feathers. Hush, folks would tell Holler. Hush! Mama and Daddy loved their son. They tried everything to get Holler to speak more softly. When he was a baby, they said, hush, nicely. When he was a toddler, they said, hush, sternly. And finally, when he was old enough to go to school, they found themselves shouting, hush! But it was no use. Every few generations, a Loudly baby was just born loud, and Holler had been a lucky one. Holler loved school. He loved art and music. He loved reading and writing, and he loved facts and figures. But every time he exclaimed, yippee-ti-yi-yo, I love math! His words came out too loud, so loud that Mr. Smarty's chalk burst into dust and the students ducked for cover. Minnie Bell said, hush, nobody cares. Jimmy Joe said, hush, you're annoying. And Mr. Smarty said, hush, no recess for you. Holler didn't like missing recess. How he wished folks didn't mind his voice. Holler loved to go to the big movie theater. He loved to stand in line for tickets. He loved to sit in the velvet seats. And he loved to see the show. But every time he exclaimed, yee-haw, I love movies. His words came out too loud. So loud that he rattled the chandelier and flattened Miss Poofy's hairdo. The ticket seller called, hush, I'm trying to count change. The lovebirds called, hush, here come the previews. And the usher called, hush, you've got to go. Holler didn't like having to leave the movie theater, but he wished folks didn't mind his voice. Holler loved fishing with Gramps and Gus. He loved baiting his hook with tamales. He loved floating in Gramps' boat, and he loved catching catfish. But every time he exclaimed, yahoo! Let's land a big one! His words came out too loud, so loud that the boat tip sending them soaring, kersplash into the lake. The catfish yelled, hush, we're out of here. Gus yelled, hush, there goes my dinner. And Gramps yelled, hush, no more fishing today. Holler didn't like being all wet. How he wished Gramps and cats and catfish didn't mind his voice. Holler was feeling blue, so Mama and Daddy took him to the state fair. He loved cotton candy. He loved the Ferris wheel. And he loved the prize-winning livestock. But when he called, "Sooey!" Holler was so loud that the hogs broke free. Then the cattle stampeded, and the whole fair shut down. Mama's patience had run out. Daddy's devotion had worn thin. But Gramps' barbershop quartet was singing in the town square. So they went to hear it. Holler loved Gramps. He loved Gramps' cat, Gus. And he loved their barbershop quartet. "Howdy! Looks like rain!" Holler yelled over the singing. "Hush!" Daddy scolded. "You're a distraction." "Hush!" Mama scolded. "Nobody can hear the music." "Hush!" the whole town scolded. "That's enough!" But so finally, Holler hushed, and the quartet crooned on. It didn't seem fair, though. Nobody was telling Mr. Smarty to stop thinking, or Miss Poofy to take down her hair, or Gus to give up fishing, or Grandpa to forget his songs. Did folks want Holler to hush forever? Being loud was part of who he was. Would they ever appreciate his company, voice, and all? Holler took comfort listening to the quartet. He loved songs about cowboys, and he loved songs about best girls. He loved songs about love and little doggies, and Holler realized something. When he was quiet, he could listen better. Quiet times could be just fine. Just then, Holler looked to the sky. A tornado! It could flatten the town! Right then, Holler knew in his heart that, sure, there were times to be quiet, but there were also times to be loud. "All righty!" he bellowed, so loud that the land rolled and rumbled, rippled and shimmied and shook. So loud that 10-gallon hats soared into the sky. So loud that Mama and Daddy, Gramps and Gus, men and women, boys and girls, sailed, whoosh, plumb off their boot heels. "Go away," Holler shouted at the tornado, which blew a raspberry at him. "I mean it," he threatened on his way to the gazebo. "Bah-ha-ha," laughed the twister. "Listen up, you big old bag of wind. This here is my town, and you'd best skedaddle." And Holler was so loud, so absolutely, positively, knee-shaking, earth-quaking loud that the tornado blew into 1,000 sweet, teeny, breezy breezes. Not one with an ounce of sass. It was official. Not only was Holler the loudest boy in history, he was also a hero. "Yippee-ti-yi-yee!" everyone shouted. "Yee-haw! Yahoo! Yahoo! Yahoo!" sang the barbershop quartet. And Mama and Daddy sighed. "All righty, in the future," Gramps declared, "when you're loud, nobody's gonna mind." So they all joined hands, cheered and danced till the cows came home. From that moment on, Holler was quiet at quiet times and loud at loud times. The townsfolks were so delighted, they put his name on a very important sign. Holler Loudly Public Library. Please hush. The end. Okay, I have to go get something to drink. I'm sorry. I have a drink on my desk. Thank you. Okay, now we're going to do 5 noisy robots. Now let's put our robots up here. Okay. Five noisy robots in the toy shop, shiny and tall with antennas on top. Along came a girl with a penny to one day, bought a noisy robot, and took it away. Four noisy robots in a toy shop, shiny and tall with an antenna on top. Along came a girl with a penny one day, bought a noisy robot, and took it away. Three noisy robots in a toy shop, shiny and tall with antennas on top. Along came a girl with a penny one day, bought a noisy robot, and took it away. Two noisy robots with shiny in the toy shop, shiny and tall with antennas on top. Along came a girl with a penny one day, took a shiny robot, bought a shiny robot, and took it away. One shiny robot in the toy shop, shiny and tall with antennas on top. Along came a girl with a penny one day, bought a noisy robot, and took it away. The end. Sorry, all that hollering gave my throat a tickle. Okay. Now we're going to read Trixie 10 by Sarah Masani and read with the permission of Henry Holt and Company. I probably won't holler as loud this time. Maybe she won't be noisy. This is Trixie 10. She has 9 brothers and sisters. She thinks they are all very annoying. Achoo! Wanda 1 is always sneezing. Thomas 2 has the hiccups. Burp! Leo 3 burps and loudly. Florence 4 giggles and giggles. Hee! Felix 5 laughs all the time. Scarlet 6 bumps into things. Oh, ow. Sammy 7 is always surprised. Wow. Emily 8 has a runny nose, but never, ever a Kleenex. Snip. Nathaniel 9 is the most annoying of all. He likes pretending to be a lion. I'm not going to roar really loud because of my throat, but you guys roar for me, okay? At nighttime, to make sure they are all safe and sound and tucked up in their 10 little beds, Trixie and her brothers and sisters count themselves in. Wanda 1, Thomas 2, Theo 3, Florence 4, Felix 5, Scarlet 6, Sammy 7, Emily 8, Nathaniel 9, Trixie 10. Trixie tries to sleep, but burp, ow, hiccup, burp, achoo, roar. 9 brothers and sisters are so noisy, Trixie sighs. It isn't any quieter during the day. 9 brothers and sisters are too noisy, sighs Trixie, and they take up too much room. Achoo! Hee hee! Roar! Hick hick! Wow! Burp! Ow! Too much noise. One day, Trixie decides to leave. She packs some useful things in a useful bag, 1 useful flashlight, 1 useful teddy bear, and 1 useful blanket. And when no one is looking, she creeps away in search of somewhere quiet. She walks and walks until she comes to a stream. But the stream isn't quiet. It is full of babbling fish. These are my 9 brothers and sisters, says a fish. They're very noisy for fish. That's just the way we are, the fish says proudly. Trixie says goodbye to the fish. Bubble, 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 bubble. She walks and walks until she comes to a meadow. So many rabbits, says Trixie. They take up so much room. These are my 99 brothers and sisters, said the rabbit happily. Trixie counts them. It takes a long time. Maybe 9 brothers and sisters aren't so many after all, she thinks. Trixie says goodbye to the rabbits. She walks and walks until she finds a big, empty, quiet place. Nighttime comes, silent and still. Trixie takes out her useful flashlight. She hugs her useful teddy bear. And she counts the spots on her useful blanket. She begins to think about Wanda and Thomas and Theo and Florence and Felix, Scarlett, Sammy, Emily, and Nathaniel. She wishes she had someone to talk to. She wishes she wasn't so alone. Meanwhile, Trixie's brothers and sisters are counting themselves into bed. Is everyone all tucked in? Is everyone safe and sound? Wanda 1, Thomas 2, Theo 3, Florence 4, Felix 5, Scarlett 6, Sammy 7, Emily 8, Nathaniel 9. Oh, where is Trixie 10? It is very dark outside and very, very scary. But they bravely go in search of Trixie 10. They walk and walk until... Boo! Do you think they're scared? It's me, cries Trixie, switching on her useful flashlight. I heard you coming. Please, cats, come home, her 9 brothers and sisters say. We miss you. I miss you, too, says Trixie, a lot. So they all make their noisy way back home. Achoo! Hiccup, hiccup, burp, roar, wow, ow! And count themselves into bed. Wanda 1, Thomas 2, Theo 3, Florence 4, Felix 5, Scarlett 6, Sammy 7, Emily 8, Nathaniel 9, and Trixie 10. It's just as noisy as usual, but that's the way we are, thinks Trixie, and she drifts happily off to sleep. The end. So sometimes noise might be not as bad as we think it is. Okay. Now we're going to sing the monster song. Okay, we're going to do... I'm not going to sing it because I'm not really sure if I can sing it right. I'm just going to say it. So, this is the way the monster stomps, and this is the way he has big feet and hairy toes. He stamps a lot. His feet go bang. And when he smiles, he shows his fangs. This is the way a monster goes, with googly eyes and a very big nose. With spiky horns and big sharp claws and terrible breath whenever he roars. Okay, I need to work on that one. Okay, loud and quiet. Quietly, quietly, not a sound. I'm listening and I'm listening as I look around. I nod, no sounds as I nod, no sounds as I clap. No sounds as I tap my hands on my lap. Loudly, loudly, stomp and clap. Loudly, loudly, stomp and clap. Loudly, loudly, stomp and clap. Whew, all that noise. Well, imagine that. Okay, final book. Can I just take a nap? What do you think? Why don't you think he can take a nap? It's by Ron Rouse. Illustrated by Rob Shepherdson and read with the permission of Simon Ann Schuster. Aiden McDoodle was tired of noise. He was tired of TV. He was tired of toys. He was tired of knocking. He was tired of ringing. He couldn't take any more of the little birds singing. There was too much noise inside and too much noise out. There was panting and pawing from his trusty dog, Scout. There were radios blaring and cars that would beep. Aiden McDoodle just wanted some sleep. He tried closing the doors. He tried covering his head. He tried upstairs and downstairs. He tried under the bed. He tried the backyard, the library, and even the park. But at each place he tried, there was a buzz or a bark. The backyard was crawling with bugs, big and small. They chirped when they heard his brother yell, "Cannonball!" In the library, the whispers built up to a riot until the librarian stepped in and shouted, "Quiet!" I don't really do that. The park roared with laughter as players cheered for their team. Then a stampede broke out when someone hollered, "Ice cream!" Noise came from all over, from up high and down low. It started out faint, but then continued to grow. There was rocking and rolling and bouncing and bumping, clanging and banging and tapping and thumping. Aiden McDoodle was hanging on by a thread. All that he wanted was his warm, comfy bed. He didn't want to yell it. It wasn't like him to bellow. But Aiden McDoodle was one tired fellow. He had tried to be patient, but they left him no choice. So Aiden shouted out at the top of his voice. Uh-oh, what do you think he's going to shout? "I don't mean to be rude, but I'm ready to snap. Can all of you please be quiet so I can just take a nap?" He had yelled it so loudly, it was heard sea to sea, from the deepest of valleys to the tallest of trees. Then all of a sudden, everything stopped. Nothing buzzed, blared, or beeped. Not a single thing popped. Not a squirt or a squeak, not a squeak from a mouse. Aiden was so happy, he ran straight for his house. He rushed up the stairs and jumped right into bed. He flopped up his pillow and then laid down his head. The noisemakers were impatient. They couldn't keep this up long without someone talking or tweeting or singing a song. And just as they couldn't take the silence no more, Aiden McDoodle started to snore. The end. I thought that one was really cute. Okay, now we're going to sing Skinnamarinky-Dinky-Doo. Okay, so let me make sure I get this one right. Okay, ready? Left elbow. Skinnamarinky-Dinky-Dink, Skinnamarinky-Doo. I love you. Skinnamarinky-Dinky-Dink, Skinnamarinky-Doo. I love you. I love you in the morning and in the afternoon. I love you in the evening and underneath the moon. Oh, Skinnamarinky-Dinky-Dink, Skinnamarinky-Doo. I love you. Skinnamarinky-Dinky-Dink, Skinnamarinky-Doo. I love you. You too, boo boo be doo, mwah. Okay, that one's fun. You guys need to do that at home. Okay, our craft this week is, because it's noise and moms, I'm sorry, but you know, the library's got to do cool stuff like make noise makers. So you can come and pick up a craft kit. You can pick one up in the children's department or at the drive-through window and make your own noise maker. Okay, now our closing song. Thanks for coming, thanks for sitting, Thanks for coming here today. Now that story time is over, I hope you have a lovely day. Come back next week for Miss Sally's Story Time. Bye-bye.